This is a pre-built version of the application. So if we go ahead and run it, now suppose we are building an apartment matching system, and based on rent, size, and location criteria, we want to be able to predict a potential new renter sentiment reaction as being positive, negative, or neutral. And suppose that X1 is the rent in dollars and X2 is the size in square feet, and X3 is the distance to downtown in miles, and X1 prime, X2 prime, and X3 prime are their normalized values. And here we are using min-max normalization, so the normalized rent is equal to the rent minus the minimum rent over the maximum rent minus the minimum rent, and same for X2 prime and X3 prime, the normalized size and the distance to downtown. And suppose we have an apartment with this rent in dollars and this size in square feet and this distance to downtown in miles, and using the three nearest neighbors. So we have a negative sentiment classification. So we predict that the potential new renter will not like the apartment. And here we are calculating the Euclidean distance in order to compare the normalized input features to the features in the data set. And this is normalized rent, size, and distance to downtown inputs. And we find the three nearest neighbors. And take a majority vote. And this is how we ended up with a negative sentiment classification. I will start by creating a new Python file. And this is training data that we will be using. So this is the rent column. And this is the size, and this is the distance to downtown column, and this indicates liking the apartment, and this disliking it, and this being neutral. And we will need to use NumPy, so let's go ahead and import it. And this class will contain the k nearest neighbor logic, and we will initialize x as a numpy array with all values set to 0 initially, and the y array will be just an array, and we will populate both of those here from the training data, and then pass them to the constructor of the k nearest neighbor class. And we will need to keep track of the minimum and the maximum and the range for each one of the features. And this method does the min max normalization, and we will call it from here. And we need to keep track of the Euclidean distance and the k nearest neighbors. And this method will calculate and return the Euclidean distance, and those are just get methods for the normalized features and the nearest neighbors and the distance. And this method will do the classification and return this symbol for disliking the apartment, or this symbol for liking the apartment, or this one for being neutral. And let's go ahead and import this text table, since we will need to use it in this display helper class. So this method here displays the initial information, and this one the initial table, and this one the classification prediction, and this classification distance. And finally this one, the classification table. And this will handle the command line entry, and we will call it from here, passing in a new display helper instance. And finally, let's go ahead and test run the application. So this is how we calculated the normalized rent, size, and distances to downtown using min-max normalization. And let's try to predict if a potential new renter will like this apartment with this rent in dollars, and this size in square feet, and this distance to downtown in miles, and using the three nearest neighbors. And we have a negative sentiment classification, so we predict that the potential new renter will not like the apartment, and those are the three nearest neighbors with the shortest Euclidean distances. And here we normalize the inputs and then calculate the Euclidean distance. And maybe let's try the same, but maybe with five nearest neighbors. So we still have a negative sentiment classification. and those are the five nearest neighbors. And if we take a majority vote, we end up with a negative sentiment classification.